Welcome to Shree Learning Academy. Our today's topic is cryptographic collision. So let's get started. Understanding collisions in cryptography. Cryptography is the science of securing information by transforming it into an unreadable format. Its goal is to ensure the confidentiality, integrity, and authenticity of digital data. However, there are instances when cryptographic operations can result in a phenomenon known as collisions. So, let's dive deep into this concept, understand its significance in different cryptographic contexts, and learn how to mitigate its potential risks. Defining collisions. In its simplest terms, a collision in cryptography occurs when two different inputs produce the same output. Imagine two distinct keys unlocking the same lock. This is what a collision looks like in the cryptographic world. These collisions can occur in different contexts, namely encryption and hashing, which we will explore separately in the upcoming sections. Collisions in encryption. Encryption is the process of converting plain text into an unreadable form, also known as ciphertext, using a specific algorithm and an encryption key. Ideally, the same plain text encrypted with the same key should always result in unique ciphertext, making it extremely difficult for an unauthorized person to decipher it. However, when two different plain texts, when encrypted with the same key, generate the same ciphertext, we encounter a collision. This situation poses a serious problem because it indicates a flaw in the encryption system's implementation or randomization. If an encryption algorithm is prone to collisions, it compromises the entire system's security, making it easier for attackers to break the encryption and access the original information. For example, consider a situation where the words yes and no both encrypt to ABC 1, 2, 3 using the same encryption algorithm and key. An attacker who knows that ABC 1, 2, 3 translates to yes might wrongly assume the same when it actually means no. This situation can lead to serious consequences, particularly in scenarios where accurate data interpretation is critical. Understanding hashing and hash collisions. Hashing is another cryptographic technique that takes an input, or message, and returns a fixed-size string of bytes, typically in the form of a hash value or digest. Unlike encryption, which is designed to be reversible, decryption, hashing is a one-way function, the original input cannot be easily retrieved from the hash value. A hash collision happens when two different data sets produce the same hash value. This is problematic because hashing is designed to provide unique hash values for different inputs, serving as a form of digital fingerprint. When collisions occur, it threatens the integrity of the hash data. For instance, let's say we have two different files, file A and file B. We use a hash function to verify their integrity, and they both produce the same hash value. An individual looking at the hash values might conclude that file A and file B are identical, which is not the case. This is an instance of a hash collision and can lead to serious integrity issues. Avalanche effect and its significance. The avalanche effect is a desirable property in cryptographic algorithms, especially in hash functions. It implies that even a small change in the input should produce such a drastic change in the output that the new hash value appears uncorrelated with the old hash value. This feature adds an extra layer of security, making it nearly impossible to predict how a small change in input will affect the output. For example, consider two nearly identical phrases, "I love cryptography" and "I love cryptography." Even this minute change in capitalization should, due to the avalanche effect, result in completely different hash values when processed through a robust hash function. Verifying data integrity. Hash functions are widely used to verify the integrity of data. When data is sent from one location to another, it's possible that it might get corrupted or tampered with along the way. By using a hash function, the sender can create a hash of the original data and send it along with the data itself. Upon receiving the data, the recipient can hash the received data and compare it with the received hash value. If both hashes match, then it's highly likely that the data is intact and has not been tampered with. For instance, when you download software from the internet, the provider often gives a hash value for the download file. You can generate a hash for the downloaded file on your computer and compare it with the provider's hash. If they match, you can be confident that the file has been tampered with during the download process. Collision detection and its importance. Detecting collisions is a crucial part of maintaining the security and integrity of data. As mentioned earlier, when the same hash value is generated from different data sets, it's a clear indicator of a collision. Collision detection is an essential part of identifying these incidents to prevent potential data misinterpretation or security vulnerabilities. If a collision is detected, typically, those data sets should be discarded or reprocessed with a more robust hash function to generate unique hash values. Hash collision attacks. In a hash collision attack, an attacker tries to find two different inputs that produce the same hash output, with the goal of deceiving the system or the user. If the attacker can convincingly substitute a malicious file for a legitimate one, based on matching hash values, they could trick victims into accepting alternate data sets, leading to potential breaches in security or data integrity. An example of this would be a situation where an attacker identifies a hash collision between a safe file and a harmful one. If they replace the safe file with the harmful one on a server, anyone checking the integrity of the downloaded file by comparing hashes would be fooled into thinking the harmful file was the original safe file. Role of hash length in preventing collisions. The likelihood of hash collisions is inversely proportional to the length of the hash value produced by the hash function. Simply put, the shorter the hash, the higher the probability of a collision. For example, a hash function that produces a 128-bit hash value will be more susceptible to collisions than one that produces a 512-bit hash value. This is because the longer hash has a much larger set of possible hash values, making collisions less likely. For example, imagine trying to assign unique numbers to a group of people. If you're using only single-digit numbers, 0 to 9, you're limited and will start repeating numbers after the 10th person, leading to collisions. But if you use a wider range of numbers, say up to 1,000, you can uniquely identify more individuals without repeating any numbers. Selecting the right hashing algorithm. When it comes to choosing a hashing algorithm, one crucial factor to consider is its ability to minimize collisions. Algorithms that produce longer hashes are generally more desirable as they offer better collision resistance. For instance, the MD5 algorithm, which produces a 128-bit hash, was widely used in the past. However, it's now considered insecure for many cryptographic functions as researchers found ways to generate different inputs with the same MD5 hash, leading to potential collision attacks. On the other hand, SHA-256, part of the SHA-2 family, provides a 256-bit hash and is currently more reliable for maintaining data integrity and security. In conclusion, while collisions pose challenges to data security and integrity, understanding their nature and knowing how to handle them effectively can significantly mitigate their potential risks. By using robust encryption and hash functions, implementing effective collision detection mechanisms, and being aware of the threat of collision attacks, you can ensure the safe handling and transmission of sensitive data. Thank you so much for watching this video. Do check out the written explanation on our website and don't forget to take this quiz based on this video. The links are in the description box below. Subscribe to our channel to watch more interesting videos. If you have any doubts, do let us know in the comment section and we will try our best to solve them for you. For private coaching, do contact us by visiting shreelearningacademy.com or on WhatsApp. See you in the next one.